In this video, you will learn how to set up a virtual private server with Linux operating system. But before we start with the actual setup, let me make a short introduction for those who are not familiar with virtual private servers. You can skip it by scrolling to this part in the video player. Virtual private server, or VPS, is a virtual machine that is usually located in a cloud. Basically, it is a system you can access remotely from anywhere, anytime. There are many use cases for such systems. The most popular one is hosting a website or a web application. In this case, you have guaranteed performance, because you get access to your own dedicated CPU, RAM, storage, and bandwidth. Better security, because your virtual machine is in an isolated environment, and unlike in shared hosting, what happens to your neighbors will not affect you. You also get complete server control, because you have root access to your server. Create a private cloud to sync your documents, calendars, contacts, emails, and passwords. Unlike with third-party services such as Dropbox, Google, or iCloud, you get full control over the privacy of your data. You can also use VPS as a private VPN to encrypt your wireless connection. VPS can also be convenient for developing and testing code. You can use it for analytics and data analysis. And if you are a gamer, you can also host a game on a VPS. Basically, VPS can do anything what Linux can do. But unlike a desktop Linux machine, VPS is more convenient. It is on 24/7 and you can access it from any system through the internet. Let's start with the virtual private server setup. I will use UpCloud as a VPS provider. It is currently the best on the market. UpCloud provides world's fastest cloud servers. You can see, for example, the performance comparison between UpCloud and Amazon Web Service. UpCloud is better in all regards. This is also supported by VPS benchmark results. This is UpCloud in terms of CPU performance. You can check other metrics here too. But it is always better to check everything yourself. You can register an UpCloud account with the promo code LU25 to test UpCloud. With this promo code, you will get $25 credits and a 7-day trial period instead of default 3 days. If you upgrade your account by depositing at least $10, all trial period limitations will be lifted and you will have full access without time or other limitations. They also offer a 30-day money-back guarantee for your first deposit, in case you don't want to continue using UpCloud for any reason, and would like to get your money back. So, you will see that promo code is applied, you fill in your username, password, and email. On the next page, you will need to provide more information about yourself. You also need to fill in your credit card information. But you won't be charged anything and you can delete the credit card information after you sign in. This is used only for identification verification and to prevent abusers, spammers, and other malicious activity. After you sign in, you will see $25 on your account and your trial mode will be active for 7 days. If you decide to deposit $10 to your account, you can do that with a credit card, PayPal, or a bank transfer. You will remove all trial mode restrictions, as I did. Next, you click on Deploy Server. You will be given a choice of server locations. You can choose one which is the closest to your location. But pay attention to the price, because servers located in Helsinki will be more expensive. Next, you choose a plan depending on the amount of resources you need. For a test purpose, you can go with the cheapest. You can also allocate more storage if you need, but it will be for an additional cost. Here, you see a selection of the most frequently used operating systems. I think Debian and Ubuntu are good choices. I will proceed with Debian Stretch, but you can also install other Linux distros from the CD-ROM tab. Optionals, I recommend to keep them at default. UpCloud also encourages you to set up an SSH key for authentication. This is highly recommended for better security, and if you know how to use SSH key, provide your SSH key here. Otherwise, skip it for now. I will cover how to use SSH keys in a separate video. In the last section, you can change the hostname. This is the name you will see when you log in to the server. The description is the name you will see in your UpCloud account. Finally, click Deploy. It will take less than a minute to deploy a server, so you can already enjoy the speed of UpCloud servers that deploy in seconds rather than in minutes. When your server is ready, you will receive an email with an IP address of your server, username, and password. You use this information to log in to your virtual private server. In the terminal, type SSH, root, and your IP address. And password? Congratulations, you have your own private server. You can start testing it, but probably it will be wise first of all to update it. Since it is Debian, we use the standard apt update and apt upgrade commands. Of course, it is subjective, but the update speed seems to be really fast. So this also proves the high performance of UpCloud servers. You can check the system information. It is Debian with kernel 4.9. There is 1 GB of RAM and 1 CPU. Also, during the first login, I highly encourage you to change your root password. You need to use the command passwd and enter your new password twice. Your password has been changed successfully, just don't forget it. There are a few other necessary security measures, such as create a regular user and do not work as root all the time, install and configure firewall, and add SSH keys. But I will cover these topics in the next videos. So subscribe and activate the bell notification and you won't miss them. For now, your virtual private server with a minimal configuration is set up. Don't forget the promo code LU25 to get $25 to your account. I would like to thank UpCloud for supporting this video and thank you for watching.